Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mariah and I am from Junk Journal Addicts. Today I want to share with you, I think, day 16, I believe. I want to make my own film strips. For that I will be using acetate, alcohol ink. And for the holes I will be using my mini shins, I think it's called. So, let's get started. First of all, I want to get the acetate in the right size. So, I think I will be... This is 6.5 centimeters and 2.6 inches. So. And we do the same over here. I hope this background will suit you, because I have removed my world map background, and this is only white paper, so I hope you can see it a little bit better now. And this one I'm going to make it a little bit smaller, 4 centimeters and it's 1.6 inch. And this also 4 centimeters. And this one, how much we going? Also 4 centimeters. A little bit smaller. And this is going to be 5, 2 inch, and also 5, and the last is almost 5, 1.8 inch and 4.8 centimeters. Now we are going to make the holes. Let me see if you are seeing that. Yes. Yep. Okay, on the other side. Okay, this is the first. Let me... Something, do you see that? I've made everywhere, both sides, the holes. Over here I'm not having a hole, but I don't mind, because I will cut the film strip in little pieces, so I don't mind if it's not quite... regular. Now we have some film strips, self-made, and we are going to use alcohol ink on the surface. So I'm going to stake some felt, and which color we will be using. Let me see, what have I do over here. Yes, let's do that. We are going to use alcohol ink mushroom, espresso, latte, oregano, and maybe some yellow and sunshine yellow. And first we are going to apply espresso, only the edge. I'm just tapping a little bit, not too much. Mm. I love the dark brown, so that's why I'm not blending it too much. And also over here. First I'm going to tap a little bit. And then another layer of brown. Because I wanted it a little bit darker. And maybe we can apply a little bit of mushroom. It's going to be under the sheet, but I don't mind because then you will get a more wrinkly effect. A little bit of yellow, not too much. Maybe some over here. And if I place it in the holes, it will get under the sheet. So I think that's very cool. I will grab another sheet so it can dry. Let me place it over here. And I will grab my alcohol ink. And let it dry. And we are going to work another one. I will place it down. And I don't mind that this is working like this. And we are just playing. So maybe over here some darker. And also over here, and maybe I'm just placing the alcohol ink not on the sheet but in the little holes, because if I do that, notice that it will grab under the sheet and then you get a more beautiful effect. I will zoom a little bit in, maybe you can see it better. So if I'm going to place some alcohol ink over here in the hole, then it will how do you say that? Thrown to the back. And I think I love that effect. And now we're going to let it dry. And we are going further with the next one. And over here, maybe I will do only this. No. We also are going to place over here some color, and here, and it's a very easy way to make your own film strips. And now a little one. Let's do some espresso and only in the holes. And over here. And some yellow. This one is almost covered the whole strip. And this one we will be using for to place some down. Okay, let's do only this. And let me see, espresso. And only on the sides. And some latte. And we are just playing around. And let me see what will happen when I throw a little bit blending solution on it. Cool. Okay. The benefit of alcohol ink that it's drying very fast normally. So I hope this also is going to dry. Okay, and now we have only two left. Let me do espresso. Only place some espresso in the little holes. And some sunshine yellow. And also this color I will be placing only in the holes. Yeah, something like this. Very cool effect, I think. So now we are going to let it dry, and then we will working with some stamps to taking the next step, and maybe we will do a little bit collage ID, but maybe we will do that in the next video. So this is part one. We are going to dry it, and once again, the first step, now let it dry. The next step, we will be using stamps to cover some ink. And the next video tomorrow will be how you can apply this in your journal. You can use it as a collage material, or maybe as a background, or you can put your own photos under it, or maybe photos from Tim Holtz. Everything is possible, so first let it dry. Okay, let me see if it's dry enough. Yes, this one is dry. This one also. Let me do this, then you see it good. Now we have this, and I hope you will like it. And we are going to use some stamps to make it even more prettier. I will be using Stamps Anonymous, Tim Holtz, Eccentric, CMS 448, one of my favorite stamps. And so, and we will be using for the ink Stazon. Why Stazon? Stazon, normally it will work at sheets, so we are going to try that. Yeah, it's not black, but it's fine with me. Oh. Ja. Let me do this one. 4.5. Another color from Stayson. Let me try this one. Stayson, how do you pronounce that? Ganache, I think. I will show you the color. It's a little bit of green, green brownish. Ganache, something like that. And tickets. And this is the color. Oh, huh? Wait a sec. Yeah. It looked like if it's black, but normally it's maybe some ink from the black is still on my stamp. And of course the little stars. Not too much. Now we have this. Wait a sec, I will put some white paper at the back so you can see it a little bit better. And this is the way you can make your own film strips. We are going to let this dry. And we will working further at the next one. Yeah. That's nice, the round one. Maybe I will do some over here also. Yeah. And let's do the other one. Yeah, that works nice. This is Wabans from Tim Holtz. And so stupid of me, because I think this is also going to work. And I'm thinking that this will work much better than the stamps. So, yeah, so stupid that I'm not thinking about that, but let me try, because this is black, so if you don't have a laser printer, you can use this, and it's more blackish. Okay, this is more beautiful. Do you see that? It's more black. Why didn't I think about that? No. No, go away. Ships. Okay, I have some tape over here, and normally you can remove the rubber with tape. Where is the beginning? Now. Oh yeah. And normally if you place the tape on the wall, yeah. Yeah, and now it's gone. Okay. Let's use another one. So now we know that if we place wabans on the sheet, that it will stick immediately. Okay. Yeah, this is cool. I like this. This is very cool. Maybe I can make some more of the alcohol ink backgrounds. So I'm using my wabans instead of the stamps, because this is a lot prettier, a lot blacker than if you are using stamps. So maybe I will make some more. Because this, I love this. Yeah, this is very cool. Yeah. Now of course, you can also use lift ink, ink lift. And then you can also use your stamps to lift the ink up. And then you are taking away the ink instead of placing stamps or wabans on the surface. So that is also a possibility. And shall we use the hand? The pointy finger. Okay. Yeah, that's also cool. This is very cool. And of course, you can use lots of colors. Maybe only black and white, or maybe pink, or yellow, or blue. Everything works. But I'm a little bit more a vintage brownish girl, so that's why I'm using the brownish colors. But this is very cool. What do you think? I will show you. This is totally awesome, I think. So let me see. Yes, let's place something over here. Maybe we can, how do we say that? Hoe zeg je zoiets? How do we say that? Control the damage. It's not really damage, but I think the wabans work better than the stamps, because I'm liking the blackage, the black print instead of the gray wind or grayish. It's not sharp. So this is cooler than the stems. Okay. I love robins because you can easily add something to your page or project, and you can see what it's going to be. And if you use with stamps, and I'm not a great stamper, so most of the times it will not working for me. So this is a very quick and easy way to get the things more prettier. And I think we are done. I will show you what we have done. Come on, okay. I will place it down on a white sheet so you can easily see what it's what the results are. This one, I have to do it. So let me zoom a little bit out. We have this one of these, and I think this one is very beautiful. This one is also very beautiful. This and this one is also fine. And now I will grabbing the next three. And I love the robins. They work very pretty at the sheets. And this one, I think this one is also very cute. This one. So, what do you think? Do you like it, or are you thinking of not for me? This is part one. Part two, we are going to use this in our journal or maybe some collage or where you can use it. Okay, thank you for watching. I hope that you liked the video. Please thumbs up, share the video. You can follow me on my Instagram account, Facebook account, Junk Journal Treasure, and of course YouTube, Junk Journal Addict. Please set notification bell on, so every day 6 o'clock I will posting a new video to inspire you, I hope. And I will see you tomorrow for part two. Bye.